Good morning. I am Dr. P.K. Asnan from Mechanical Engineering Department. I am going to teach you today the course of Mechanics of Material with code BTME 2008. Today we are going to discuss the topic of thermal stresses from Unit 1. I hope you will enjoy the digital learning experience of this course. Recapitulations. So first we will discuss what we have discussed in previous lecture. In the previous lecture we have first studied the Saint-Venant's principle, then we studied Hooke's law, strain and shear strain. We defined modulus of elasticity and modulus of rigidity. We established the expression for simple deformation in the bar. And lastly, for bars of varying cross section, we discussed the principle of superposition and how it can be applied to the numerical problems. To continue further, let us see what we are going to cover in the today's lecture. The objectives for the today's lecture are, we have to determine the extension of rods of conical section in continuation to the previous lecture. Then we will apply the similar rule for the extension of rods of trapezoidal section calculation. We will also see what happens to different bars of different section under self weight. In this continuation, we will first try to study a rectangular rod which is hanging from the top, and under the self weight its length is going to increase. So that would be known as the deformation under the self weight, and it is very important for calculation of the deformations for the vertical rods which are supported at the top. So next we will change the cross sectional shape of a vertical supported rod to the conical rod, and we will see how a conical rod behaves under the self weight for the deformation characteristics. In the last, we will move on to the new topic, and we will discuss what is temperature stress, why it is caused, why it is important to control the temperature stresses, how to evaluate the temperature stresses. So that is the today's lecture outline which we are going to cover. Bars of tapering section. If you see, there is on the right hand side of the slide, you will find that there is a circular bar. If you see the side view, you will immediately know it is a circular bar, and this big end is having a diameter capital D, while the other end, smaller end, is having a small d diameter. The total length of this bar, conical bar, is L, and we are considering a section at a distance x from the small end, and take an elementary strip of thickness delta x. The whole bar is subjected to the tensile load P on the faces. You see there are two forces P which are equal and opposite, acting at the opposite faces of the bar, one at the big end, other at the small end. So if you consider the diameter is changing from small d to capital D over a length L. So the rate of change of the diameter would be the total change in diameter over length L. So per unit length, the change would be capital D minus small d divided by L. And if x is the distance, how much increment in the diameter will happen? It would be this rate of change multiplied by the distance x, length x, and then you will add it to the this increment to the minimum diameter, that is small d. So that would be the diameter dx, because you see from the figure the diameter dx has to be bigger than t. So it is an addition of increment. So this is the interpolation formula for the diameter at a distance x from the small end. Now we consider this elementary strip of distance at the distance x of thickness delta x. So if you want to calculate the elementary extension, that is delta of delta, capital delta, small delta of capital delta, that is only the extension of this shaded small strip, it would be having the, we have to apply the formula which we have studied in the previous lecture, that PL upon AE. So P is the load we have taken here, is load is also P. What is the length of under consideration? Delta X is the length of the elementary strip under consideration. So it would be P delta X and divided by area. How much is the area of this strip? The area of a strip is pi by 4 dx square, because dx is the diameter at distance x from the small end. So that is A multiplied by E. So this becomes your elementary extension of the this shaded strip. If we integrate the this extension from small end to big end, we will get the total extension of the whole rod. So in order to get the total extension capital delta, we integrate this elementary extension within limits 0 to L, that is along the complete length of the bar. And then we put the delta expression here. And since it is a small element, the approximation delta x can be converted into exact differential dx, because it is when the partial derivative is the dependence upon the single variable, the total differential and partial differential becomes one and the same. So del x becomes dx. And now we can perform the integration with respect to x. So it comes out after substitution of the limits as 4PL divided by pi e small d times capital D. So you see, this is becomes the expression for bar of tapering section. Now can we check whether our formula is matching with our traditional formula PL upon AE? Look at the case. What is the top expression is still PL, and consider a situation where the small d and capital D are same. So if small d and capital D are same, the area becomes pi by 4 d square. So that is the same. So this formula reduces to PL upon AE, or if the dia of the bar is uniform, and that is matching to the what we have studied in the last lecture. And hence we are sure that our this derivation is also correct. Now let us consider another case. Here the bar is of the trapezoidal section, and that it is a trapezoidal section. The cross sectional area at the end, big end and the small end, is a rectangle. The rectangle has a uniform thickness, bar has a uniform thickness T throughout the length. So you see here also, and at the big end also, at both the ends, small end and big end, the thickness of cross section is T. However, at the small end, the width is the height which is looking in the figure is small b for the rectangle, and for the big end it is capital B. So once again we take a similar elementary strip at a distance x from the small end of the elementary thickness delta x. The total length of the bar is L. The bar is subjected to equal and opposite tensile forces P on the big face and small face. So what will be the width bx at a distance x from the free end? Definitely it is more than small b, the distance at the breadth at the low end, small end. So it has to be small b plus some increment. And how much that increment would be? If you look at the rate of change of the b, it is capital B minus b divided by capital L is the total length of bar. So that is how much it is changing from small end to big end. And multiplied by this is the rate of change, multiply by it by the distance x from the free end, you will get the increment in the width b, and this becomes your increment. After adding it to small b, you will get the breadth at the distance x. So what becomes the area at this elementary strip? It becomes bx into t, where bx is this expression given here. Now let us consider the elementary extension of this strip, that is small delta of capital delta. That would be equal to PL upon AE, and P is the load which is shown in the figure. L is delta x for elementary strip under question, that is the length of elementary strip. P delta x. What is the area of elementary strip? The area of elementary strip is bx into t, small t, because uniform thickness is there of the beam, and the height at this section is bx of this elementary strip. So area is bx into t, and then e. So this becomes synonym to PL upon AE, and hence it gives you the elementary extension of this elementary strip. If we are interested in finding out the total extension in this bar, then what we have to do? We have to perform integration over this quantity. So that's what we have done here. In order to get the total extension of the whole rod, we have calculated the integration within limit 0 to L for entire length of the beam, the strip, elementary strip extension. So that becomes 0 to L, and once again the partial differential del x is converted to perfect differential dx. So it becomes 0 to capital L P bx t e into dx, and if you perform the integration, you know it becomes equal to the bx is changing with x, so it becomes a function of the dx, and hence since it is 1 over bx is in the denominator, the integration will be logarithmic of the length. So it becomes PL upon TE B minus B log E base B capital B over small b. So capital B is the width at the height of the elementary strip at the big end, and small b is the height of the strip at the small end. So this becomes, make sure that whenever you are calculating it, remember this is not log base to 10, but it is log base to e, that is natural logarithmic. In your Casio calculator, you have to use the function ln, not log, because log is refers to the in the calculators to base 10, while the ln is synonym to log base e. So always take this precaution while performing calculations on your engineering problems. Second precaution you should take, that you should be careful about the units in which you are substituting the load, P, length, Young's modulus, etc. In order, they have to be consistent in order to get the correct results. Now we come to the elongation of self weight, elongation due to self weight of a bar. So here we have a rectangular bar which is rolled, which is having the area A, and that is uniform in diameter, and then we are putting it under the self weight. So if the density of material is significant and length is high, the self weight becomes considerable, and whatever, if you see from the lower end, consider a section of at the elementary thickness delta x at a height x from the bottom. So the area below this strip, the unshaded portion of this bar which I am highlighting right now, this weight acts on this particular day x section and pulls it downward, and that causes the extension in this elementary strip of length delta x. So how much would be the weight of the unshaded area which I am highlighting with laser pointer right now? That would be, let me call it as w with suffix x. So what would be the extension? The extension would be wx means load, that is p. Then how much is the length of a strip? That is delta x. So it becomes pl, and the denominator remains ae, where a is the area of cross section of the rod and e is the Young's modulus. So if you put there, now I have to find the value, substitute in this expression the value of wx. So the weight of the volume here, so what much, how much would be the volume of this unshaded area which I am highlighting now? The area of this beam is cross section is a, and the length is x. So in order to look at the totality, it is the volume is area into length, that is a into x. So you see, this is ax into volume, volume into density into the acceleration due to gravity gives the weight wx. So wx becomes rho times g times volume, that is a into x. And the rest of the quantity, this is delta x upon a, remains the same in the expression. Now this, you see in the numerator and denominator, you will find that the a is can be cancelled out. And so after cancelling the a area in the numerator and denominator, we get the expression rho g x delta x upon e. So the extension of the whole rod becomes delta equal to capital delta equal to integration of this elementary extension over the length from 0 to L, that is within limits 0 to L. For the entire length of the rod, it has to be integrated. So now we substitute whatever we have done here in the above expression here, and we integrate it, the g, integrate 0 to L rho g x dx upon e. And on integration, we will get a quantity rho g L square upon 2e. And if you try to multiply, you break L into two parts, that L into L, and you multiply the numerator and denominator by area A, then rho g A L becomes the total weight of the rod, that is W. So I substitute rho g L as W here, so it, the expression becomes W L upon 2 A E. And you remember your simple case of the beam. You see here the total extension is WL upon 2AE, where W is the self weight of the bar. So what will happen if the self weight of the bar is not considered, and instead we consider a force with vector magnitude W on towards the downward on the same rod? So the extension would be WL upon AE. But here in under self weight, it becomes exactly half of that. So it becomes WL upon 2AE. Hence we can say the deformation of bar under its own weight is equal to half the deformation due to direct load and equal to weight of the body applied at the lower end. Let us come to elongation due to self weight for a conical section. In conical section, we have a tapering bar where the diameter at the lowermost point is 0 and at the top it is capital D. So if this becomes a perfect cone with length L. So if you consider a distance from the apex or the bottom where the diameter is 0, at a distance x, vertical distance x, we consider an elementary strip of area A, and the thickness of the elementary strip as delta x, where L is the total vertical height of the cone, the elementary extension of the strip would be once again Wx upon delta x, Wx into delta x, that is PL upon AE. So Wx is the weight of this unshaded portion towards the bottom side on the elementary strip. And how much is the weight? The weight is nothing but density rho multiplied by force of acceleration due to gravity, that is g, and the volume. So the volume is equal to 1/3 of the volume of the cylinder. So that is a into vertical height x upon the 3. That much is the volume of this conical section, which is below the elementary strip, as I am highlighting right now. So it is ax upon 3. So Wx becomes equal to rho g ax upon 3, and the rest of the quantity, that is delta x upon AE, remains as it is. So on simplification, you see the area at the top numerator in it cancels with the area A at, in the denominator, and hence the expression reduces to rho g x delta x upon 3E. Now we come to we want to calculate the extension of the whole rod, because we have already found the extension of the elementary strip. How we can do that? We can easily do that by performing integration from limit 0 to capital L, that is from apex to the top surface which is supported at the roof. So we perform the same thing. So we get the total extension of the whole rod on the integration of from 0 to L, integration of elementary extension delta times capital delta. So we substitute the expression we have, which we have calculated for the extension of elementary strip here, and then we perform the integration, and it comes out to be rho g L square upon 6E. So you see, in the previous case it was upon 2E, and in this case it is upon 6E. That means it became 1/3 of the that of the rectangular section which we have studied in the previous case. Hence we can say this elongation of this conical bar is 1/3 that of the rectangular section of the same length under its self weight. So that is the relationship between these two cases which we have studied here. Thermal stresses. So let us see what is the thermal stress and how it can be calculated. As in the video we have already shown, it is very significant to calculate the thermal stresses, otherwise it can cause fracture in the body. So let us try to estimate the thermal stress. So consider a bar which is shown in figure here at the top, right hand top of the slide. You will find that this is a bar with length L, and when it is heated to a temperature change T, say T amount T degree Celsius, then it extends by an amount delta, small delta, if it is this end is free to move. When this is end is free to move, there is no generation in stress of the rod. No generation of stress in the rod, because this expansion is unchecked. However, if we check this extension by providing a rigid support on other side too, that is the rigid side on both on left side and the right hand side of the bar, what will happen? You can consider this as a case in which the initially the rod extends, the initially at stage 1 the rod is of length L, then temperature increase is by T degree Celsius, it becomes L plus delta L, then the rigid bar, rigid support pushes it back by an amount delta. So the stress generation would be equal to the strain in the body which is generated by pushing by this amount delta, which is equal to the thermal expansion of the rod. So that is the concept how we calculate the stresses. And if you see at the last line, the what would be the delta value here, the delta extension, thermal expansion would be proportional to the length of the bar, original length of the bar L, and multiplied with the coefficient of thermal expansion alpha, and with multiplied by the change in temperature T. So delta equal to L alpha T is the formula, and also delta is nothing but deformation. Deformation is equal to this sigma L upon E. Sigma means P upon A. So effectively it is PL upon AE, P upon load upon area we have taken as a stress. So it becomes sigma into L upon E is equal to delta. So from here, if we equate this expression, you can find the stress sigma becomes equal to this expression which I am highlighting right now. So length on both sides, left hand side and right hand side of the expression cancels, or sigma becomes equal to E times alpha T. So the thermal stress becomes equal to the coefficient of thermal expansion alpha with multiplied by rise in temperature of the bar by T degree Celsius, and E as the Young's modulus of elasticity. Similarly, this becomes thermal stress. We can also calculate thermal strain. Thermal strain is nothing but thermal stress divided by Young's modulus. And thermal stress we have already calculated as alpha TE, and that is divided by E becomes equal to alpha into T. That is the coefficient of thermal expansion multiplied by rising temperature. So we have to remember a point that the stress is only generated if the deformation is checked. In the case A, the deformation is unchecked, and hence there would be no generation of stress. However, in the case B, when the rigid support is not permitting any deformation due to the rise in temperature, then only you can say there is a stress generation, and the amount is equal to sigma equal to alpha into T into E, and the thermal strain equal to alpha T. Now, what will happen in the third figure, which I have shown in the bottom, is the case C. It happens that rigid support is not able to sustain the stress which is being produced in the bar, or the bar is pushing with this equal and opposite force on the rigid support, but the support is yielding and it moves back and it permits an extension by small amount A. So what becomes the net extension, net contraction, net expansion which has been checked in the bar? That becomes equal to the next action, net action capital delta minus A is the expansion checked by the rigid support. So that becomes equal to L alpha T minus A is the new extension which is checked by a yielded support by distance A, and this should be equal to sigma L upon E as we have done in the previous case. So now we can see the stress is reduced in the bar by which can be calculated by expression L alpha T minus A in bracket multiplied by E upon L. So this becomes your new stress, and if you refer to the previous case, this is reducing because it has a quantity subtracted from this expression, that is minus A. Similarly, we can now calculate the thermal strain in this case, which will also be less than the case B. That would be sigma upon E, and that becomes equal to L alpha T minus A divided by L. So these are the thermal stresses if thus in the case the support is yielding by an amount A. Now let us consider one more case. the bars which are subjected to the thermal stress are not always of the constant cross section. So let us try a simple case where the bar is tapering from a small diameter d to capital diameter at the other end, big end, at a distance L, which we have already shown seen in the simple case. And the load to which this tapering bar is subjected is P on the opposite forces. So what will happen? For the bar of tapering section, we have already seen the deflection, the elongation delta is equal to 4PL upon pi e small d into capital D. So that is equal to the thermal expansion here. That deformation is equal to thermal expansion. And how much would be the thermal expansion? Thermal expansion would be equal to length of the bar multiplied by the coefficient of thermal expansion multiplied by the temperature T increase of the body. So L alpha T. Hence we can calculate the from this equivalence expression the load P which is on the right hand side, and the P becomes equal to alpha T E into pi D capital D by 4. So this becomes your net force on the body P. Now once we know the load in newtons on the any surface of the body which is generated by the checking the thermal expansion of this bar, you can easily calculate the stress, because stress at any section would be the load divided by area. Now you see area in this beam is changing from area minimum at this small end to area maximum at the big end, and hence these two has to be seen. So where would be the stress maximum? The stress maximum would be where area is minimum, that is at the small end. So if we substitute the minimum area which is equal to pi multiplied by d square by 4, small d, not capital D, because the area has to be taken minimum, the maximum stress comes as the alpha T E D by capital D by small d. So you see once again, if the bar is of uniform diameter, the small d and capital D become same and they get cancelled out in numerator and denominator, and sigma and max becomes equal to alpha T E as we have calculated in the first case in the previous section. Hence we are sure, since it is reducing to the already derived expression, we are sure that the expression which we have derived for the tapering section, which is shown here, that sigma maximum equal to alpha T E D capital D by small d is also correct. There are two questions, numerical problems, which I am giving you as a home assignment. The first one is about the temperature stresses, in which two cases. In one case the support is do not yield, and in the other case the support is yielding by 2 mm, that is small a in the lecture is equal to 2 mm, and then we have to calculate the stresses. And then in the second question we have a trapezoidal section bar which is subjected to some load, and we have to calculate its elongation. The references for the today's lectures are, the textbook is S.S. Ratan as usual, and the reference books are Timoshan Cohen Young and R.K. Bansal. So that brings us to the end of this lecture. Thank you very much for patience learning, and happy learning. Thank you very much. Good day.